Generally, I think of eternity as God's domain and time as mine. Yet, time is a gift. Time holds the most precious of gifts because it is in time that we experience the very presence and life of God. But it's not so much that we must search and find God, but rather we need to open our eyes and our inner eyes, because God is always present. Never is there a time when we are without God. Never is there a time when we are without God. The rock star Bono, the lead singer of the Irish band U2, is heavily involved in work to alleviate the AIDS epidemic in Africa. In one of his talks, he was relating a story. He said, "A number of years ago, I met a wise man who changed my life in countless ways, large and small. I was always seeking the Lord's blessing. I was saying, 'You know, I have a new song, look after it, Lord. Or I have a family, please look after them. Or I have this crazy idea.' And this wise man said, 'Stop. Stop. Stop asking for God to bless what you are doing, but rather get involved with what God is doing, because it's already blessed. All time, all the things.'" So tonight we're asked, what piece of God's work or God's project is God calling us to do as the people of God? At this time in our life. But then we might say, "But I'm too busy. I'm forever rushing from one thing to another." We rush from the breakfast table, even if we sit down at the table. Finally, we fall into bed exhausted, only to begin the same routine the next morning. Advent calls us to make a little space in time for connecting with God, so that gradually God's presence becomes a habit in our life. Learning to know God, not just knowing all about God. This Advent, my prayer, is that we may consciously choose to live as if God's presence invades us, invades all men and women, invades all human experience, invades every part of this natural world, invades every aspect of our daily life, all the time. After all, it really is God's time. God bless you.